Project Guru.
Всем привет! С вами Зак Новак на радиостанции Novorossia Rocks. Welcome to Novorossia Rocks Radio Station in downtown Donetsk. Project Guru. Guru's in the house. Guru, thank you so much for all the hard work that you do. Andre, my engineer, thank you as well. My lovely co-host Natalia is on vacation. Let's start right away. Guru, check this out. Kiev Junta's barbaric attacks on Orthodox churches in Ukraine are unacceptable, Moscow has stated. Right sector nationalists, Nazis attacking Orthodox churches in Ukraine are unacceptable, the Russian Foreign Ministry said on Tuesday following meetings between its special representative for human rights, democracy, and the rule of law, Konstantin Dolgov, and the leadership of the Vatican Secretariat of State and its head, Richard Gallagher. The two sides discussed in a constructive manner in the spirit of consolidating the partnership cooperation between Russia and the Vatican, pressing aspects of humanitarian human rights issues, the ministry noticed. They expressed serious mutual concern over religious harassment, above all of Christians in Middle East and North Africa. The Russian side pointed to the unacceptable practice of attacks and seizures of cathedrals and property of the Ukrainian Orthodox Church of Moscow Patriarch in Ukraine by radical Nazi nationalists, often with the involvement of local authorities. The parties agreed with the need to boost further efforts to keep the problems of violation of religious freedoms in the world in the focus of attention of the relevant specialized multilateral institutions. They pointed to the importance of continuing the work aimed at strengthening traditional values in the world, including family values, countering attempts by a number of Western countries to impose neoliberal concepts and policies, the Russian Foreign Ministry said. Guru, listen to this. Explosion hits Poroshenko's Russian shop in Kharkov. An explosion has hit a Russian shop in the city of Kharkov. Ukrainian police department in the Kharkov region said on Wednesday at 1:37 in the a.m. an explosion at the Russian shop located in the Dafi Mall was reported to the police call center of the Kievsky department. This according to Union News Agency in Ukraine. No one was injured in the explosion, police said. Shop windows and doors total damage by the blast wave. Investigators, prosecutors, representatives of Ukraine State Security Service are working at the scene. Explosion on Poroshenko's chocolate factory. Guru, Turkish junta regime again silences journalists. Imprisonment and deportation. Russian Foreign Ministry Special Representative for Human Rights, Democracy, and the Rule of Law, Konstantin Dolgov, has stated the necessity of a harsh OSCE reaction to the deportation of Russian reporters from Turkey. Deporting the Russian reporters without explanations, the Turkish authorities continue trampling on freedom of speech and access to the media. Ankara's disregard for its international obligations requires a harsh reaction from OSCE and other relevant international organizations. On December 7th, members of the crew of the special correspondent program of Rossiya 1 TV channel were detained in the Hatay province in southeastern Turkey, bordering Syria, as they were going to the neighboring province of Gaziantep, the ministry said. The detention was carried out by unknown persons wearing civilian clothes who, in reply to the journalist's legitimate request, refused to introduce themselves or let them see their IDs. The Turkish authorities refused to give explanations to representatives of the Russian embassy in Turkey, who got in touch with the crew shortly after its detention. We strongly condemn the illegal actions of the Turkish authorities. Such attitude towards the media is absolutely unacceptable. The ministry also said it was curious as to what rules had been violated by the Russian journalists. One gets the impression that Ankara is scared that correspondents of the Rossiya 1 TV channel may throw spotlight on facts about the illegal activities carried out in the Turkish-Syrian border area. Turkish government would prefer to keep it in the shadow. The Russian Foreign Ministry noted that the incident was quite telling in the light of a series of violations of the rights of the local and foreign media in Turkey. The international organization, including the OSCE, have repeatedly drawn attention of the world public to this. In this regard, the detention of editor-in-chief of the Turkish daily newspaper, Kan Ozan Dundar and the newspaper's Ankara bureau chief Erdem Gul in late November over a report about the involvement of the Turkish intelligence agencies in the supplies of weapons to ISIS in Syria is indicative in this respect. The journalists were charged with espionage, disclosure of state secrets, and terrorism. They are facing life in prison, the Russian foreign ministry said. Andrei, good news. Homes back in control of Syrian government, Viva Assad. Syrian so-called moderates have begun evacuating the last district they hold in the city of Homs under a ceasefire deal reached with the government, monitoring groups and activists said. The deal means the entire city returns to government control, Viva Assad. Those leaving are due to go to areas of Idlib province still in rebel ISIS hands. Homs in central Syria was once dubbed the capital of the revolution and saw some of the first protests in 2011. Buses arrived on Wednesday to transport fighters and their families out of Homs, suburb of Al-Wair. Activist network, the local coordination committee said. About 800 people, including moderate ISIS fighters and civilians, are due to depart throughout Wednesday, the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights said. Fighters linked to Al-Qaeda are among those due to leave as well. Under the UN-backed deal, food aid has reached the suburb for the first time in nearly a year. The Syrian Red Crescent tweeted in Arabic that it seems we're operating in the area, but few details were available on the conditions on the ground. Ahead of the deal, the Syrian authorities said they released 35 moderate opposition fighters. Again, that's moderate opposition fighters detained in Homs. We wish for the best, said one resident. What do? We want just safety. An estimated 75,000 people still live in Al-Wair, down from about 300,000 before the start of the Syrian crisis. Some Syrian activists argue the deal is effectively a surrender forced by punishing blockades, but others have defended the truce struck in Al-Wair on the grounds that some groups will be allowed to have control over their own communities. Viva Assad! For our friends, DPRK, North Korea, Russia will support China, and on December 10th, it will vote against the UN Security Council discussions on human rights in North Korea, DPRK, Russia's ambassador to the United Nations organization, Vitaly Churkin, told reporters on Tuesday. He said Russia's position is that every UN structure should mind its own business. For discussions on human rights, we have the Human Rights Council, which considers all countries, including the DPRK. This is where those issues should be discussed. The Russian diplomat said as the December agenda for the Security Council was put together, it did not contain a word about a meeting on human rights in the DPRK. This situation does not require urgent attention. It is not a new situation. Thus, as far as the procedure is concerned, it causes inconvenience. The situation around human rights in DPRK was put on agenda of the UN Security Council a year earlier, despite objections from Russia and China. Before the first meeting on the topic on December 22nd, out of 15 member countries of the Security Council, 11 countries voted pro. In voting procedure issues, decisions are taken by a majority of the vote, and the right of veto is not applicable. Guru, former commander of Bosnian Army, accused of war crimes committed on Serbian civilians. Former commander of the 3rd Corps of the Bosnian Army in 1995, Sakib Mahmuljan, is accused on 3 counts: war crimes against prisoners of war crimes against the wounded and sick, war crimes against the civilian population, according to the local police. Former commander Sakib Mahmuljan was arrested on Tuesday in Sarajevo on charges of committing war crimes, local police said. The detainee is accused on 3 counts: war crimes against prisoners of war crimes against the wounded and sick, war crimes against the civilian population. I had to repeat that, Guru. A statement by the Bosnia and Herzegovina law enforcement reads, Sakib Mahmuljan was the commander of the 3rd Corps of the Bosnian Army in 95, when Bosnian Mujahideen killed 50 Serbian prisoners of the Bosnian War. According to the prosecution, Mahmuljan knew about the plans by the Muslim militants to kill the prisoners, but failed to hand them over to the military police or prevent their murder. On November 21st, 95, a 3-year civil war in the Republic of Bosnia and Herzegovina ended between the Serbians, the autonomous Bosnian Muslims, and the Croats after a ceasefire agreement was reached. The war claimed the lives of over 100,000 people and forced more than 2 million people from their homes. Finally, Guru, let's see what happens here. A Bosnian is accused of war crimes. Let's see how far The Hague and the United Nations, the War Crimes Court, will carry this. Finally. Guru, Sister Republic Lugansk, calls out Poroshenko's junta's army. You are no match for us. Viva Lugansk. The Kiev junta leadership understands that it cannot win if Ukrainian forces launch a new offensive in Donbass. The Lugansk People's Republic head Igor Plotnitsky said on Monday, only real combat actions can demonstrate how our forces are prepared. Judging from the way Kiev is acting, they understand very well what they will have to face. That is why I personally think that the Ukrainian president, Nazi Petro Poroshenko, does not have enough gunpowder for such actions. Foolishness may be sufficient to launch provocations, but they need to have capabilities to win. LPR People's Militia repeatedly stated that Nazi Ukrainian armed forces regularly move personnel and military equipment to the contact line in Donbass, including those weapons prohibited by the Minsk agreements. LPR noted that multiple rocket launcher systems were spotted, along with self-propelled artillery systems, tanks, and mortars. Earlier today, the Donetsk People's Republic Defense Minister's spokesman Edward Basudin said Ukrainian junta forces have moved 467 units of artillery, armored vehicles, and vehicles with ammunition to the contact line in Donbass over the last week. He said that among military equipment spotted on the Gorlovka direction, 123 tanks, infantry fighting vehicles, armored personnel carriers, 27 Grad multiple rocket launcher systems, 31 cannon artillery systems, 2 self-propelled artillery systems, and 1 Buk missile defense system. Guru Andre, listen to this. Plans are advancing in the far eastern Kamchatka Peninsula for a holiday hotel made of ice and snow, a local tourism official said on Wednesday. It will be built in 2016 using Canadian and Scandinavian technologies. It will be unique for Mother Russia. The establishment will open on March 1st near Kamchatka's famous hot springs, accommodating 15 guests at a time, paying 6,000 rubles per night with full board. Furs will cover the floors. Guests will rest in sleeping bags designed to withstand the cold, and the restaurant will serve food and drinks in dishes and glasses made of ice. Norway built the first snow and ice hotel in 1991. They can now be found in Finland, Sweden, Romania, Canada, and Alaska. And now, an ice hotel in Kamchatka, Mother Russia. All right, folks, that ends our program. See everybody on Friday, and I stress, everyone be safe. Viva Assad, viva Mother Russia. We're going to be ending our program with Christmas songs all the way till the holidays. Happy Christmas, John Lennon. See you on Friday. Bye-bye.
So this is Christmas, and what have you done? Another year over, just begun. And so this is Christmas, I hope you had fun. The near and the dear ones, the old and the young,
a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
So happy.